What was before a mini-boss is now a regular enemy. And damn. And gives me no money. Hits like a bitch, though. Hits like a shit. Oh, that wake up. He just slaps you in the fucking gob. Gone with that 51. Oh, the kicks to the shin. You're a bitch. I hate you. Come on, give me something out of this. Nothing? Oh, that's some double dragon shit right there. With the conveyor belt leading to a pit. That's it for that. I hate how these guys give me nothing. Got you all in the corner now. What you gonna do? What you gonna do, huh, bitches? Huh? You just got launched. Oh, laser beams! I can't even fight the laser beams. Why one would even... Oh my god, rat traps. Those are definitely like Ninja Turtle rat trap throw-offs. Definitely, just little blighters. Oh, this is... Lucky. Stupid lucky. Guns. Oh, ooh, may cost me an extra life. Do you know how long it took me to assemble the league? Like 2 hours. Oh, you bitches. I don't even know who's hit me off screen. Somebody. Okay, it was just one of the two robots. But man, they were getting some hits in. Getting some good hits in, though. Couldn't believe so much even after the big fight with Giga Gideon. That's craziness. What? Oh, yeah! The 7 evil ex-girlfriends. Because he was cloning her, Scott's evil exes. Oh my god, I completely forgot about this. Oh, dogpile on Scott. Give me one of your electric rods. Now you're fucked. Now y'all have done made a mistake. Oh, I'm dead. Proper dead? No, back up. Got me up the sweep. Give me that. Holy shit. Yeah. Grinding for that money did all the difference in the world. Holy shit. Wow, what was that? Who hurt you? Well, me, obviously, but I mean... Fucking hit me like I owe you money. And then again, I'm hitting you pretty fucking crazy back as well. Crazy sexy cool. Oh, wow. Huh. The Techno Shack. It's, This item is sold out. Alright. Microwave chicken. $40 a pop? I guess I'm gonna sit here for a moment. Just to get my health back up. Couldn't give me anything better than something that $40 a pop. Okay. Excellent. Can't believe, well, I guess since my stats are maxed, fighting software would be pointless for me. Damn. Bitch is tough. Stop blocking! Stop hitting me! Might have to go back for some more roasted chicken if this keeps up. Wow, okay. Yeah. Just gonna go back for the couple pieces of chicken. Energy tank, how about that? Oh, I could get it to go, that's so great! Wait, did that give me 42 off the... Whatever. I just got a Mega Man-style E-Tank. This is a Ubisoft-published game. Fucking made by nobody associated with Capcom. The fact that they could get that is incredible. That and I've come into this with a weapon. Okay, Gideon. So... Gideon Graves, age unknown. Is this a real Gideon? Power unknown. Oh, him and his pixelated sword. Damn, that wake up. And his clearing ability, too. Oh, shit, that's a good combo. I'd be a happy boy if I could just keep you in this pattern here. Just gonna sit here and zap you for the rest of your days. Man, what a ripping fight. I'm gonna take a look at chat. Nobody's there. Well, shit happens, at least. Oh, no, he finally broke himself out. Holy Christ. Get... And just keep beating on you like this for a little while, then. I'd love it if I could just get in with the punch combo, but I feel like he'll be able to break his way out. Oh, now he's flashing. Let's see. Oh, no, I don't think he's in faster flashing yet. It's probably going to take a little bit of time for that. Shit. I think Mr. Chow is tougher than Gideon. At least I couldn't cheese Mr. Chow. He wasn't fucking having none of it. Didn't have a weapon to do so. Oh. Damn. Woo! Woo! But was that the real one? No, that was a robot. Okay. Sure. Right. Where's... Oh? Oh, that's some Dr. Wily shit right there. I'm so happy I have a knee tank. That's funny. I like that. We gonna do a Robotnik, or, are you gonna run away? You gonna fight me normally? Oh, yeah, that is 100% a fucking Wily. He exploded into a pretty sizable amount of money as well. Really? Yeah, let's just get to Scott on the final placement. that's pretty awesome. Okay. What do we... Uh-oh. Is there a runaway scene, or... No, you got it covered, right? Gubby, quick, just in case. Oh? What do we have? Place explodes. Just a rain cloud over top of... Okay. I love how it's the overhead view of the map with a little dot. That is super cool. That is really... It's a pair of underwear hanging off the flagpole with hearts.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. And so... Scott was saddened by Ramona's departure.
What?
But only for a little while. Look at that. Soon he was dating Knives, Kim, and Envy all at once. He was the happiest guy in the world. Or was he? What? What ending is this? Is this a bad end? I guess since I'm playing on, like, Average Joe, that's the ending. Maybe? Perhaps? Wow, that went a hell of a lot quicker when you're fucking super jacked up and strong. Ubisoft. Fucking Ubisoft Montreal, of course, for a game based off of comic book character from Toronto by a Canadian artist, based on the only press graphic novels by Brandon Lee O'Malley, developed in Kim Pine, awarded Shopping Frenzy, Julie Bleep, Envy Adams, rating 100%, Ramona Flowers, American, management producer, Caroline Martin, Jean-François Vallée, Montreal, Quebec, what do you expect? Kim Pine, rating Rock Socks, Stacey Pilgrim, setting Scott straight again, production manager, Marc-André Boivet, Project coordinator, Levi Yu, Scott Pilgrim, totally disturbed. Kim Pine, less angry, rating hot. Knives Chow, 17 years old, rating twice as hot. Kim and Buck and Knives are kissing there. Scott Pilgrim, girlfriend kicks ass. Knives Chow, Ronin Roven Revolution expert. Level designer by Zhu Baixi, Yang Kai, Scott Pilgrim, new move to unlock. Wallace, Scott's gay roommate. That is Wallace Wells, okay. Wasn't too sure. Art by Paul Robertson. I believe a lot of the guys that did this game, I don't remember what the development team, job defeated other species, Ruxilia hates his job. I don't remember any of this shit. They did Mercenary Kings, I believe was a game that came out on PlayStation 4 because the art style is fucking exactly the same. Mike, rating weakling. Doberman, hungry. Doberman, growl. Doberman, woof. Fuck, I forgot. Scott Pilgrim, dating Ramona. Ramona Flowers, relatively mysterious. Zombie Lucy, Samo, kung fu, amazing. Oh, they cut through this shit a little bit too quick to get the whole... everything that's happening. Robot 01, Robot Jiu-Jitsu, Robot Chuck wants to be a robot too. They found out that he wasn't one of them. Illustrator, Crash and the Boys, but that's not Crash and the Boys, they got like weird goggles on. No, that is Crash and the Boys. Best time, 39 seconds. That's a very Mega Man inspired sounding theme, if I'm not mistaken, that one there. Negascot. Antimatter. Wolverine status needs to recover HP. Ryan, something. Charles Tremblay. Jason Kim lives a life a kilometer at a time. I guess that's, Jason Kim. I don't know who the fuck that is, actually. Must be a character from the comic that one day I'll sit down and read the comic. Brad, status stunned. Alberta, rating 11 out of 10. Fucking A, 11 out of 10, Alberta. Oh, tell me about Super Chunk. I'm kind of curious about her. What's her deal? Buta, technique, ninja magic. William, status, empty stomach. They're going for the chicken. Arigato, Mr. Roboto. Super fighting robot prototype of the Kazinger. Like Mazinger Z, but it's a Kazinger K. That's a good one. I like that. That's a good joke. Gideon Graves. Status? Lost in the void. He's gonna try to get to that goddamn door and get back. Music performed by Anamaguchi. Of course it's Onomonoguchi. Kyle K, Handsome Jerk, Ken K, Perfect Asshat, Mr. Chu, Rating Deadly, Matthew Patel, Angsty Fist? Angie Fist? Yeah. Shit. Oh, wow, to think that the first level took me almost an hour to beat because I was hitting dudes for three, and then the last seven took me roughly about another 2 hours to beat just because I was hitting like a motherfucking freight train. Can't stop, won't stop, like a freight train, goddammit. Oh, man. That was great. That was fun. It makes me want to rewatch Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, because that is one of my most favorite films of all time. Showed that to a few friends a couple of years ago, and they're like, you like this movie? I'm like, go fuck yourself. This is fantastic. It is crazy. It's erratic. It's referential to video games. Tons of fucking references in there. Shit that I didn't even get until, like, I never played Legend of Zelda The Link to the Past, but they use that tune once or twice. I'm like, holy fuck. It's just really cool. The amount of Nintendo noises that they managed to license for that film was astounding. And hell, the amount of references in this game were pretty damn solid as well. The first level, I didn't even notice many of them, but there was quite a few in the later ones that I was actually paying attention to. The Montreal QA team. Hey, no. The guys I follow from, were formerly super best friends, were a bunch of QA testers in Montreal, but that was for Eidos. Nah, I don't think any of them would have touched a Ubisoft game. But you never know. They managed to outsource them sometimes. I think there was one game one guy got outsourced for Mr. Kowalski. Or Kowaleski, sorry. He was outsourced to do some QA on Wet, but they never gave him a test unit, so he almost got fired. They're like, why haven't you been testing? And he's like, I'm still waiting for a unit. And I'm like, wow, you should have mentioned it to someone. He's like, I mention it to somebody every day. Localization, hey? I wonder. Yeah, just with a different, like, French, of course. And, yeah, I don't know what other languages this game probably came out. Well, here they are. French, German. That was it? I would have expected more. So apparently, Italian, that works too. You can't buy this game anymore, which is a goddamn shame, because, well, I bought it years ago. I haven't locked my PlayStation account, which is great, but there was like, what was it? Ninja Turtles Reshell. I remember another girlfriend had that one, and we played it a few times on her account, and then, well, we broke up, and I never got to play it again. Still achievements in that game, trophies I'd like to get, but then again, for this game, shit, I've had it for probably 10 years now. It would have come out in at least 2009, because I believe that's when Scott Pilgrim vs. the World didn't come out until 2010, maybe 2011. God, I need to check on that. Ooh. If I ever have money again, that may be one of the purchases that I consider going for is the whole Onipress collection of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Or I could probably just find it on a manga site and read it from that. Please support the official release. But if you don't have the money to, support it when you can. How's that? Onyx Team. It's not the people that are the actually like full-out developer on this. The Onomonoguchi tunes just don't stop either. Fucking great, too. Maybe, no. Yeah, I think it's because of that. Because I listened to a Nerdist podcast for, years. I've listened to pretty much all 998 or whatever number they're up to now. They're way up there. I think they're coming up to 1,000 pretty goddamn soon. And for a very long time, maybe still. No, I think they switched off of Onomonoguchi around episode 900 or something like that. I don't know I don't know if it was when they had changed over to the ID10T podcast or what it was, but... I think Anamanaguchi did a lot of music work for fucking... There was another kind of 8-bit style television series I'm trying to remember. I haven't thought about it fucking forever, though. Code Monkeys. Wow, that takes me back to the old tech TV days of TV shows of just nerd shit. Oh yeah, Ubisoft credits. Gonna be sitting here for another 45 minutes, didn't expect that. Oops, forgot. But yes, fucking Code Monkeys. I wonder if you can find that shit anywhere, or if that was something that never got licensed outside of... Probably had to have been licensed outside of tech TV, but... I don't have TV anymore, and I don't see something like Netflix getting something like that. But then again, I wouldn't have imagined that Netflix would have gotten season 3 of iDrops. Now, if you're not aware of what iDrops was, it was a CG short skit shows that were about 3 to 5 minutes long, maximum. Some animation, some claymation, but... a lot of it CG, and this is like early 2000 CG. I was watching this shit while I was still in high school. Fucking grand, fantastic show. And it was all just, there's a better thing to call it than skits, but I can't think of the word right now. It was, but then Netflix just recently comes out with this series called Love, Death, and Robots. And I'm like, first episode's 17 minutes long, that's a little bit weird. The concept is fucking great. I'm just like, this is super cool. And then it goes on to the next one, completely different concept. And all the visuals in that is just fucking stunning. What they can do with computer technology nowadays and just rendering out these light models and skin depth. And apparently it was like the brainchild of the head of Blur Studios, who was also the director of Deadpool, the Deadpool movie. And Blur Studios, like Blur Animation, they've been putting out fucking fantastic CG. They're the ones, I believe, are the guys that did the Killzone 2 teaser trailer for E3 2012, I think it was? No, maybe? No, 2012 might be way too late. That was a PlayStation 3 title. That was like 2006, maybe. Holy shit, yeah. And yeah, Blur Animation Studios have just done fantastic, beautiful work for years. And to find out that they were the ones behind this Love, Death, and Robots is fucking amazing. Just, the different visual styles, the different stories that they told. Some of them fucking haunted me after the fact. Some of them I was just inspired by watching. And the only thing I had a bit of an issue with was, I think about 3 episodes in, it was based off of, fighting off these giant hordes of creatures. And then the very last episode was the exact same premise, but, in a completely different setting, a much more realistic thing, and different visual style entirely, but it was still the same basic premise. A bunch of people have to fight the endless hordes of creatures, and I'm just like... this is really cool, but hey, come on, you've done this idea. There's so many ideas out there. Everything else was a complete stark contrast from one different story to the next. But yet, you had to retread a little bit of territory on this one. I guess you guys had a hell of a lot of fun with that overwhelming hordes of monsters tech that you developed. Or something for the AI characters to interact with each other in a way where it's might have been procedural or something, just having them go about. It's goddamn, it was really cool. Now, trying to fill time talking about something other than the fucking video game is getting a little bit difficult, but. I don't know if there was any other media for Scott Pilgrim that had. Was, come out, or had, if the author had done any other comics based off anything else. And even the end of the video game doesn't cover 100% what the end of the manga, or comic, or however you want to describe it as, is North American produced, but I call it a manga, because kind of just had that that feel to it. Holy fuck, this came out in 2010. No pixels were harmed during the making of this video game. Zaijian Games. Zaijian? Maybe that's not... Maybe that's just a... Yatta! You did it! Hooray, the end. Thank you for playing. Thank you for making a great game. Damn. It's always nice. Always nice to see that. I guess I'll hit a button? Game over! But then I get good end. Extra game mode. So we have Battle Royale and Dodgeball. Score ranking. Sure. And... yeah. I guess if I go through in like rough and tough or something like that. So now, I don't think the path to the radio tower ever opens up. Or at least I don't know how. Everything is unlocked and go to any battle along the way. Don't really care for that. So that's a strat. Save a bunch of money, get yourself super jacked, and you're fucking untouchable. Untouchable. My goodness. That and you, while you're grinding for the loot, you get a shitload of moves and levels as well. So there you go. There you have it. Garrett's Dreams. Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, the game. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, take her easy.